I'm going to simulate keyboard input in C# by implementing SendInput from this code project download. In my project, I include InputSender from the downloaded project and change the namespace. I'll start with a type function that will press all characters in the passed string. First, loop and get each character. Get the scan code for each character. If shift is required, then press two keys at once. If not, call the input sender click key method to press one key. Get scan code returns the scan code for every character. The default is 00, indicating no key. Shift required will return true if the character is in the defined array or is uppercase. PressCombo accepts two scan codes, then call SendKeyboardInput for key down for both codes, then call SendKeyboardInput for key up for both codes. In the start button click event, I'll test the type function in Notepad. First, send the form to the back, then sleep so I can activate Notepad, type all numbers, type lower and uppercase letters, and type non-alphanumeric characters. Then bring the form to the front. Run it. Press start. Make Notepad the active app. And you can see it typed everything. For navigation keys like the enter key, I create individual functions that accept a count and call input sender click key with the scan code. I create similar functions for tab, delete, and the arrow keys. For the control and alt keys, the function accepts a character and calls press combo to press shortcuts like control V. I'll change the script to use navigation and control keys. Press control A to select everything, delete it, then type new tab lines. Run it. The last thing to handle is extended keys like page up. I create a function called pressExtended that will send two keyboard events. The first is the extended key flag and the second is the pass scan code. Then call pressExtended from the individual functions. To test it, I'll keep page up and type a line above the text that's already there.